So my name's Collis. I do indeed work at Envato. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Envato. But before I tell you a bit about the company and community, I wanted to get a quick show of hands for if you, before you became a professional community person, if you were just a regular community member of some community that was influential to you, just a show of hands. So, cool, me too. I was in a couple of communities actually that were a big influence for me. The most recent one was iStock, which is like this place where you buy and sell stock photography and things. I was part of it before it went mainstream. It was like really little and indie, run by this Canadian guy with tattoos named Bitters, who was really into photography and democratization and crowdsourcing. And it was a really cool community. They had like meetups around the world called iStockalypses, and it's cool. Do you think that's neat? They also had the Steel Cage, which is actually nerdy Photoshop battles, but sound cooler if it was called the Steel Cage. I got in said Steel Cage on a forum from the comfort of my home and lost a Photoshop battle or two. It was a really neat community, and I guess I got to see a lot of stuff about how communities could be run. That one was quite influential, but not as much for me as the one before when I was really just getting started. I used to study math once upon a time. I was not very good at it and decided I needed a career change. And I ended up on this website called DeviantArt, where you do like Photoshop and stuff. And I got really into it, made bad Photoshop with other people. They chatted. They told me I was doing better than I actually was. Years later, I looked back and was like, not really. But it was really cool. I got connection, I got inspiration, I got people patting me on the back, and I got really into it. Had a t-shirt, it said DeviantArt. Fortunately, the words were really close together, and it kind of looked like it said DeviantTart, which is would be okay. It's just normally I tell people about my DeviantTardiness the second time I meet them. So DeviantArt was... maybe the third. DeviantArt was an important formative experience for me, and I guess these community experiences then gelled into when we started the company Envato, which has been heavily influenced by my ideas from being just a regular old community member, an active participant. Although in my case, I was a bit more of a lurker, I guess. So I was influenced by community experience. We run three products, Envato Market, Envato Studio, and Tuts Plus. Envato Market lets people buy and sell everything you need to do marketing campaigns, website builds. So you can buy WordPress themes, stock photography, video, audio, all kinds of things. Envato Studio, you can hire freelancers. And Tuts Plus, you can learn different creative skills, just all kinds of stuff. We're by creatives for creatives, so I was a designer eventually. Eventually, I did get a little bit better, and I married a designer, my wife, Cyan, and she and I, along with my best friend, who happens to also be a designer, we started the company, and we did it really in making a company which was for other creatives like us to sell their stuff, and later to learn how to become creatives, and later to do freelance work as creatives. We're bootstrapped, so to this day we've never raised any capital, which means that we know nothing about investment or venture stuff, but lots about doing things on a shoestring, having no money, borrowing from your in-laws, that kind of stuff I'm really good at talking about. I've talked about startups. So we're bootstrapped, and that's been kind of cool, especially as a community company, because it means that we have been able to stay especially true, I think, to our mission. So the company, as you know, is a community one, which is why I'm here to talk to you. And the community is at its heart, it's on forums. I think forums are probably the heart of most good communities. We're on social and blogs as well, but the forums is like the beating pulse of the community, where things go awry and things go well, and there's flame wars and weird threads and all kinds of stuff. Social blogs are like the sort of maybe a one tier out, and there's occasional offline meetups and things like that as well. Predominantly our community are the people who sell on Envato Market or on Envato Studio or Tuts Plus. They have probably the most vested interest in chatting with other people. But we also get people who purchase or people who are learning or staff or the whole lot on there. It's quite a substantial community. So we get something like 30 million visits every month. There's 4 million members, 1.5 million of those are active buyers. There's something like 30,000 people actually selling, and 70,000 people have posted on the forums at one time or another, and there's a little over 1 million people follow us on different social channels. So it's pretty substantial and pretty big. Obviously, as you guys know, communities don't start out that way. They take ages and ages to build, and initially it was very little. But over the 8 years that we've been in operation, it's gotten quite big. And one of the interesting things for me is that community, this is a double robotics. I don't know if you guys have seen those. It's like an iPad on wheels. It follows you around. It's super creepy. they come into meetings and stuff. So we have a lot of remote staff. Sometimes the remote staff dial in and then follow you around. I tried to dial in and face planted. So I'm like, it was 1 hour into our purchase. It's like $1,000 robot thing fell down. But it was okay, which is cool. That's not what I'm here to talk about. Though doublerobotics.com, feel free to go visit. Community business is what I'm here to talk about. So it's interesting to me, community is a bit fluffy, I often feel. So sometimes I'll meet someone and I'll be like, oh yeah, we're a community company. And they're like, "What? I don't know what that is. What does that mean?" Especially the more businessy they are, the more I feel like, oh, I need to show you that this could be a real businessy thing. So I found an interesting study from the Harvard Business Review and eBay. They got together back in 2006 and they took 140,000 active eBay sellers, so people who in the last 3 months had bought or sold something on eBay, and they split them up into two, into a control group and a group to be experimented on. So it's a little bit weird, but anyhow, they experimented on these people, they offered them incentives, they got them involved in the community. About 25% of those people actually did get involved. They either became active community participants, I think 5%, and 20% became lurkers. Lurk is such a horrible word. What have you been doing today? Just lurking. Lurking in someone's backyard. Community versus control. What was interesting is they bid 6 times more often. They were much more likely to become first-time sellers, and they spent 50% more. So people who had become community enthusiasts, even if they were just lurkers, even if they just like creepily wandered around eBay's community looking at stuff, turns out that they were much, much more active. So I feel like community, although it can be a little fluffy, it can also be quite a substantial economic driver. There's all kinds of community businesses, as you guys know, content businesses like Wikia or Reddit, 500 pixels for sharing photos. Marketplaces are often slightly community-ish just because you have all these sellers and buyers getting involved and they can become quite active. Envato obviously falls in that bucket. Software, we're often in the WordPress space because we sell a lot of WordPress themes, and WordPress is a really cool community as well. So today, what I wanted to share with you is 5 lessons that I've learned in our time building a community business. The first one seems kind of straightforward, but it's a people business. At the end of the day, if that doesn't sound awesome to you, don't do it. Sometimes I meet people who are like, wow, you built such a great community. That must be really a great asset. You know, we just like added some forms of surprisingly nothing happened and we paid no attention to it, but don't know why. You really need to want people to succeed if you're going to be in a community business. And there's obviously lots of positives, and I think you guys know most of these purpose and economic drivers, and it can lead to much higher engagement, gives you a direct line to the customer so you can hear all from them. You can build certainly a product ecosystem around your product. People start building apps and plugins and all kinds of things. But married with that is a lot of downsides. Loud stakeholders who are very, very loud sometimes. there's a lot more accountability, lots more responsibility to those stakeholders. They're really invested, especially so for with Envato, we have all these thousands of people who make their livelihood with us. So they earn their entire income from us. So when we make some change, you can be sure you will hear from them. Most of them are designers, so when you change something about the design of the site, you also hear from them. Sometimes they design stuff for you. Some of them are coders, so they tell you how to fix your site. It's kind of cool. It's quite different to not hearing from your customers, though. Sometimes it's blissful having a bit of silence, whereas when you have an active community business, you hear from them, which is pretty cool on one hand, has some drawbacks on the other. emotionally charged, can be quite emotionally charged. As I say, when you're earning your whole income, you can become quite upset if you're a bit suspicious of what's going on. They need a lot of attention. I don't think you can have a thriving community if you're not paying attention to them, actively improving the sites. I think you need to genuinely be passionate about people. For me, actually, I'm a bit of an introvert. I don't really like people up close and personal, stress me out a little bit, but the abstract online person I like. far away. Quite happy to do things for them. And the number two lesson that I feel I've learned over the years is that win-win really works for a community business. So you want to have a symbiotic relationship with your community, something where when the community is doing well, the company is doing well. So in order to do this, obviously, you need to understand what your community cares about and try to align your incentives. So for us, when our authors sell more, we make more. That's good. Feels like a nice balance. And we're very careful to craft our entire business around the community doing well. I think the moment that shifts, the moment you start to lose touch with the community, and it can go pretty bad sometimes. Your community is always a bit suspicious of your motives. I've been working with the Envato community for 8 years, founded the company. I do my level best to be an active community member, to make sure that the company does good things. They're always still a bit suspicious of me, a bit suspicious of our team. I think that's right, that's logical. You know, at the end of the day, we're a company. And I think the sort of counter to that is to make sure that it's sort of baked in that you're gonna have a win-win philosophy. So the company and the community are sort of stuck together at the hip. It gives you the best chance of the community staying at just suspicious and not going into paranoia, not going into outright rebellion, which sometimes they do. Obviously, you guys are familiar with lots of famous community rebellions. Dig.com is the one I always think of, where everyone just stormed off and went to Reddit. That is another of the drawbacks. Your entire customer base may leave together. I don't think that happens for most companies. This kind of leads me to the third lesson, which is, I guess, a conglomeration of the first two, which is to bake these things into the company. So as a company grows, and today there's something like 250 staff at Envato, and it's pulled in many different directions. We're getting bigger, there's a bigger community, and one of the things that happens with such a huge community is you have lots of different people who want lots of different things. The staff want one thing, that sometimes different portions of the staff want different things, different products need different things, different community members need different things. So you want a compass to help you get through all of that. Something to guide your decisions. For us, it's our values. So we created a set of values. The first one being, when the community succeeds, we succeed. We said, let's just bake this right in so that it's kind of stuck into the company and we can't get away from it. Big fan of things that you cannot get away from. I like the idea that I tell new staff that our values are like, you know, when you play cards, sometimes there's like a special card you can always pull out. Someone else plays the king and you're like, I've got the ace of spades. Sorry, you lose. That's our values. I tell our new staff, our values are the ace of spades. So, you know, no matter what else happens, you can always pull this out and make a decision based on it. So as an example of this, a while back, we had a product manager who was like, we should have paid search listings. So on our marketplaces, there's millions of dollars going through. There's lots of incentive to get up the top of the search rankings. Why don't we start charging people for it? We'd totally make lots of money. It's not really very good for the entire community, probably would benefit a few affluent members of our community, but the whole community, not so much. You'd end up buyers with getting things that people had paid to show, authors from or sellers from countries with less financial worth wouldn't be able to get up the rankings. It feels like it would create imbalance, so we didn't do it. Although we would have succeeded, the community wouldn't succeed, therefore it was the wrong play for us. We've got a community goal, so we set the entire company on a particular goal, which is a community earnings goal, so that all of our efforts are aimed towards making the community succeed. By definition from our values, therefore we should succeed. So our goal is to get to $1 billion of community earnings. We're actually really far away. Then we're at 200 million, which is kind of cool. Still lots of zeros, but still a long way from a billion. We report, so we have to report quarterly back to the company. I get in front of the entire company and explain how we've helped the community succeed that quarter, and we report annually to the community. Actually, only done that one time, it only just started, but it sounds better if I said it annually rather than one time last December. So totally gonna be annually as of this December. In a community company, I think everybody at some level is a community manager. I think it's not just one person or one team's job to be the community managers. We actually have some of our Envato community managers right here, but it's not just for them. Community is for the entire company. So we encourage everyone from our lawyers to our product to our dev to get on the forums and actually chat to community members, to come to community meetups. And we do lots of other things. So when a new person starts Envato, we induct them into the community. We teach them all about our values. We tell them all about the community. Sometimes I think we could do even more. Nat, our Envato Market community manager, and I have been talking about more ways that we can induct people into the community. But we already do a pretty good kickoff. We have global meetups where you can staff can actually physically meet community members. We profile the community in videos and interviews, and we have a video at the end of this presentation to show you so you can meet a couple of community members. We hire from the community, so some of our staff are actually from the forums, which is kind of cool. No better way to have people who understand and know the community than to actually get community members working at the company. We have people visiting in the office who are from the community, just hanging out, sitting at the desk somewhere. And we encourage all of our staff to become authors, sell on Envato, use the products. We also do lots of community product development. I'm not sure how many of you have done this, but it can be a bit tricky. Your community has a lot of views on how things should be, especially when they're web developers and designers. They have very specific views about how things should be done. Nonetheless, we try to get them really involved with discussion, interviews. We publish an annual roadmap. Once again, we've only done that one time, but this is totally going to be annual as of next February. We survey them, we do testing with them. We try to get them involved in the product development. This is has, as I say, positives and negatives. So the positives of a community in product development means that you get instant feedback. The negatives are you get instant feedback about your changes. And sometimes it's brutal, but it's good brutal. We encourage all of our staff to do their own launches and communications, so you don't just go to a community or communications person to do the launch. You have to go out there and tell the community about the thing that you've just built. It's almost like an initiate rite of passage, I think, for new product managers to launch their first thing on the forums. Our last announcement for reference was like 800 posts long. About 400 were critical. It wasn't our most successful launch. And actually, I'll get to that last lesson in a moment. So the fifth thing is that community, for me as CEO, is the most important part of my job. This is a couple of weeks ago, I did the ice bucket challenge. I don't think the team who got the ice right understood it was meant to be ice water. We're actually just over there at the back filming. It was just ice cubes. I got home, my wife was like, what's with all the cuts on your head? It's like, it's charity, baby. nothing to do with this slide. Community is my most important job. At the end of the day, community is a people business, right? People operate on trust. I don't think that people trust companies, though. I think people trust other people, which is why for me leadership and managers are so important throughout the organization. No matter how big or small your organization is, the people who are running it are the most ambassadorial, if that's a word, which it now is, community members. Your leadership, your managers need to be comfortable getting out there, getting on the forums. They need to be community ambassadors. They need to be personable. It's important that as a community member, you're not just the worst thing is occasionally we'll hire someone whose first comments sound like they're speaking in marketing speak. I'm always like, oh no, it's like normal people. You're just supposed to speak like a normal person. And it's okay if you've done something right, say, hey, I think this was right, and justify it. If you've done something wrong, say, no, oh, we did it wrong. Sorry, we'll do it better next time. You need to be able to carry through change. Sometimes that's kind of hard with active forums, vocal community members. You need to be a real person, empathetic, honest, trustworthy. I think there are community in my mind can smell a fake. They can tell when you're inauthentic. They know when you're hiding something. I don't know how they know. It's kind of creepy. They're really good at it, figuring out if you botch something, if you're trying to cover something over. I've discovered it's much better just to be very, very straightforward. Another of our values is tell it like it is. All the times I can remember in our history where we haven't told it like it is, I've always regretted it, and we've ended up telling it like it is. That's, in my opinion, it's a much better policy to establish trust through openness and transparency. Actually, in my experience, the community doesn't care if you get things wrong. That's okay. It's okay to get things wrong. It's not okay to pretend it was right, which is really tempting. You know, you want to be right. You're a human. You don't want to admit when you've gotten things wrong. But for me, that's probably one of the most important things for a leader of a community business, is to be comfortable saying, I totally botched this. This was wrong. So our last product release, which had 700 posts inside of like 2 days about it was just a new feature. Anyhow, totally got it wrong. Went back and was like, time out. Please stop posting. We're going to go back and get more data and try again. And that's okay. So community at the end of the day is purpose. And purpose is important. I don't think at the end of the day it is about business drivers. While I do feel that community can be an economic driver for a business, I don't think that's the reason to operate a community business at all. For me, creating a community business is much more about making the experience that I had as just a community member, which was that experience of connection, encouragement, involvement, just being a part of something, I guess. I feel it's an increasingly disconnected world. It's nice to have different ways of connecting with people, whether it's through an online community or one that spills offline into other mediums like Facebook or whatever it is. I feel our jobs as community and social managers is that much more important because of the way that the world has gone. And what I wanted to end on was just a little actual video of some community members. Two of our team, we sent them around the world to video different people from the community, and these are two of them.
I'm Irina Trepovska.
And I'm Ivan Gaševski. We are both from Skopje, Macedonia, working as graphic designer specialized in logo design and brand identity.
We are also known as Unipen team on Envato Studio.
Skopje is one of the best cities in the world.
We love Skopje.
Yeah, we totally adore it. Skopje has a great urban culture. Everything around us inspires us. The building, the city, the trees, the nature.
The people.
The people also inspire us. There are plenty of historic museums that once you visit them, you get really, really impressed by the work done so far by many, many good Macedonian artists. We are taking a lot of inspiration from that as well.
We've been together 13 years.
And we are already working as a team for more than 6 years. And now we live together as well.
Yes, and we do together everything. We started using Envato Studio like 6-7 months ago for our vacation.
It was summer, so we are on the vacation.
We were very surprised because we got our first project in less than 24 hours.
Yeah, and we thought that it's a luck, like, okay, we got one client, it's okay, it's nothing, but
after that, we got 10 new
projects in the next couple of days, so we had to pause the service so we can continue working on the projects. So the mistakes that I will make, she will correct them, and the mistakes that she will make, I will try to correct them as well, because two heads is better than one.
Almost every day while we are drinking our coffee and
smoothie. We look at other showcase websites. You just see what they are doing. You got motivated, inspired from the whole day. You're just boosting inspiration and start working.
And logo design is important to be good in black and white and inverse, to work on a stamp, to be from small size to a big size.
Yeah, you always need to think how it will look on a pen.
Functional.
Functional, yeah. It's not like in the fashion design where trends are for this year or this season, then the next year it's all history. It needs to be long-lasting, and the longer it lasts, the better the design is. Every job we get, it's different because the client is different, the country is different, the culture is different. So all those differences make you more interested into design. One of the good things that gives satisfaction is when we give the three concepts, for example, a couple of concepts, and the client say, okay, now I have a problem, which one to choose?
Yes.
Or say, wow, this is amazing. So those are the...
We are like that.
Yeah. We are happy, very happy, yeah.
They're like super cute. Every time I'm getting trolled on the forums, I'm just like, no, it's people like that out there. It's okay, be a bit more patient. Yeah, so that's all I wanted to tell you about today. Thanks so much for having me.